Hi everyone! Today we're going to talk about how to use transformations to sketch the graph of a function. To complete this problem, we'll first sketch a small piece of our function, then modify it one transformation at a time until it represents the complete function. Let's take a look. In this particular problem, we've been asked to use our knowledge of transformations to sketch the graph of y equals 1/2 e to the negative x minus 1. And all I want to show you here is that you can sketch the graph of a function that you know, and then use your knowledge of transformations to build out the rest of your function. So what I mean by that is we could, for example, recognize that we have e to the x. This function here, or this part of our function, e to the negative x, is just e to the x, but with a negative x substituted in. So what we could do is we could start with the graph of e to the x, and if we know what that looks like, it's a common function, it might be a graph that we know. We can start with that, and then we can change e to the x into e to the negative x, and then we can apply the 1/2, and then we can apply the negative 1. So here's what that could look like. We could sketch the graph of e to the x, and that looks something roughly like this. You may know that it's a curve that looks like this. It intersects the y-axis at y equals 1, and this would be e to the x. But we don't have e to the x, we have e to the negative x. So what we want to do is recognize that all we've done here, right, this function is f of x equals e to the x. Well, we've gone ahead and said f of negative x because we're plugging in negative x for x. Well, what we should know from our knowledge of transformations or our study of transformations is that if you plug in negative x for x into a function, it's just going to flip the graph across the y-axis. So we're going to have the same function, except that it's going to be backwards like this, flipped across the y-axis. So again, we'll intersect the y-axis at y equals 1, and the graph is just flipped across the y-axis like this. So now we have the graph of e to the negative x. Well, our next step is to apply this 1/2 here, right? We need 1/2 times e to the negative x. So what we want to do in that case is say this is going to be the graph of f of x equals 1/2 e to the negative x. And we know from transformations that multiplying by 1/2 means that we're going to shrink the graph vertically by a factor of 2. So instead of the graph intersecting the y-axis at 1, it needs to intersect at 1/2, and every y-coordinate will be half what it is. So if this y-coordinate here, for example, were 4, our new y-coordinate here will be 2, y equals 2. So we just shrink by a factor of 2. So I may not draw this perfectly, but maybe what that looks like would be something like this. We'd intersect at 1/2, we know that, and we would have every y-coordinate be half of what it used to be, and that would be 1/2 e to the negative x. And then our final step would be to apply this negative 1 here. We know from studying transformations that adding a negative 1 like that is just going to shift our graph down one unit. So if we're talking about f of x equals 1/2 e to the negative x minus 1, we have the same graph that we did over here, except we move it down one unit. So instead of intersecting the y-axis here at 1/2, we're going to be intersecting at negative 1/2. So that'll look something roughly like, we call this negative 1/2 here, something roughly like this maybe, negative 1/2 here, and that would be the curve like that. So it's a little rough, but you get the idea. So as you can see, we started with e to the x, and we just manipulated that one step at a time using what we already know about transformations to sketch the final graph of y equals 1/2 e to the negative x minus 1. So I hope you found that video helpful. If you did, like this video down below and subscribe to be notified of future videos.